One more time.
One more time.
Hi, I'm Nat.
And I'm Lo.
And this is Nat and Lo's 20% Project, where we go around Google learning about all the stuff we're curious about.
And today, we're going behind the scenes of the new Google Voice.
Which is not Lo.
So, a few years ago, Google added voice search as one of the ways you can search for something. And if you've ever tried it out...
Okay, Google. How tall is an elephant?
African elephant has a height of 11 feet.
You've probably noticed that computer voice that talks back to you.
We got word that there was a team at Google creating a new voice for the Google app, and we got really excited to learn how do you actually create a computer voice.
So we got into the recording studio and met James, the voice coach, and Erica, a linguist, and the new voice talent.
So this is silly.
Yeah, this is totally silly. So you guys are on camera, and I don't have to be seen.
We're invading your home.
I love it.
When was the first text-to-speech voice made?
The main thing that we think of as speech synthesis mostly started in the 80s.
Back then, they were using an approach that was completely computer-generated. But now, how text-to-speech voices are typically made is that a person records thousands and thousands of sentences. And then, out of all those sentences and all the sounds that they contain, magically, a voice is made.
When we do speech synthesis, what we're doing is stringing together units of sound to combine them in new ways to make new speech.
Units of sound can be phonemes,
the smallest unit of sound that distinguishes meaning. So from stack to slack, suddenly it's a completely different word. You've changed the meaning just by swapping one sound for another.
Bones.
I can think of eight kinds of tea, eight flavors of tea in English. Those are phones.
Top, top. So you see the paper moved when I said the T, but what happens if I put an S before top? Stop, stop.
And diaphones.
It's essentially the transition from one sound to another.
What is the sound of an S before a W? What's the sound of an S before an I? What's the sound of a T at the beginning of a word?
Erica and James told us that the bulk of these recordings are for getting good diaphone coverage because these transitionary sounds are really fundamental to how speech works.
So once you're done and happy with what you have, then what happens?
Then the recordings are kind of stored in a database.
Any content that hasn't been pre-recorded would have to be stitched together.
It's essentially a search problem. It'll be like, okay, I need to put this sound with this sound with this sound. Let me look through the recordings, and then stitches them all together into smooth speech.
Synthesized speech can be great at taking text and turning it into speech on the fly, but it can kind of end up sounding a bit robotic.
So probably one of the biggest reasons that the team is creating a new voice is to do more detailed recordings that will add more nuance to how the voice sounds.
A typical grilled cheese sandwich made with two slices of white bread, margarine, and 26 grams of processed American or cheddar cheese contains 291 calories.
I think my favorite part is sandwich.
Really?
Yeah.
The way
Play sandwich again.
A typical grilled cheese sandwich made
sandwich. I love that.
So a big problem in speech synthesis right now is prosody and intonation,
which means the way the speech sounds, its rise and fall, its rhythm and melody.
Let me give you an example from just regular language. What's your name?
Lorraine.
What's your name?
Lorraine.
So the first time my melody went down, when I was a request for repetition or for clarification, my voice went up. Mm-hmm. We've never been able to do this before.
To try to add all these different layers of melody and stress and intonation and, you know, whatever other nuances that we have when we speak, the team has been doing these recordings that are almost mini plays where James, the voice coach, acts as a user. And then the voice talent can respond back in different ways depending on different situations.
Okay, Google, I need to send a text.
Who do you want to text?
Madison.
Madison, sure. Mobile or work?
Mobile.
What's the message?
So the user just dictated the message.
Got it. Here's your message. Do you want to send it?
Actually, no.
Do you want to change the message? Do you want to change the message?
That was good. That was lower. Yes. That was the right. Nice. That was the right pitch.
Key.
Yeah.
So the new voice will actually be a combination of these whole chunk recordings along with splicing together units of speech.
We wanted to understand how it feels to actually be the person who's expected to be the new computer voice, so we asked the voice talent if she had any tips for us.
It takes a lot more energy and air than you think to keep the voice going and to keep it energetic and clear.
So I have to learn in the next few minutes to speak from my diaphragm.
To speak from your diaphragm. It takes a lot of energy.
Okay, Google, I need to put something on my calendar.
When's the event?
Tuesday.
At what time?
It sounds a little bit tense, and you're starting a little bit high. Think of it as a smooth figure skater on ice.
At what time?
Okay, a little lower.
At what time? Sorry, what's the day and time?
Now let's try one like this. Sorry, what's the day and time?
Sorry, what's the day and time?
Ooh, that was really good.
Happy with it, guys?
I liked it. That's a wrap.
That's a wrap.
That's a wrap.
So it was great to have been in the room, even to just see this little snippet of what goes into recording a voice, because it really made us realize not just, of course, how complicated language is, but how much more goes into language than just the words. I mean, hearing the different ways you could deliver something and realizing what a difference that actually makes in terms of somebody's understanding in the context is very humbling. I mean, it's not something we walk around in our day thinking about because it's not something we have to think about. And yet, if you're gonna make a computer voice, it makes a big difference.
Thank you for watching Nat and Lo's 20% Project. No, wait, let's try that again. Okay. Thank you for watching Nat and Lo's 20% Project.
Bravo. Yay. I mean, it sounds good to us. All right.
600 feet, turn right.
What time is it?
Step away from the mic. Step away from the mic.